Welcome back, everybody. So this is kind of part two of the DRS modifications that I'm making. So I just finished cleaning this up and I'm about to take it out of the chassis and start making some modifications to this ACC Elite. So the things I'm going to be doing today are I'm going to be machining out the space where the air gauge goes, and I'm also going to widen and reshape the access area to the hammer spring. I think that this chassis is perfectly fine the way it is, but I wanted to put a 28 millimeter gauge on the side instead of the 23, and I would like it to be a little bit easier to adjust the hammer without kind of messing up the Cerakote and stuff once I put that on here. So that is what I'm going to do today. So all you have to do to get these out of the chassis is take out these two action bolts that are in the bottom. So the front action bolt is a 4 millimeter and this rear one is a 3 millimeter. You can reach the rear one without taking off the grip, but it's a lot easier if you do. So you just take off the two side screws, and then underneath the flap in this MDT grip is a T25 Torx bit. And once you take off the grip, you can get a lot easier access to that. So once you take this off, you just simply lift upward. And it is a very tight fit. So if you lift upward and kind of give it a little boost from the bottom of the plenum, it will come straight upwards. And there you go. So I got this separated from the block, so let's get working on it. All right, so this is the part of the chassis right here that I'm talking about that I'm going to Dremel out a little bit. Kind of has this stepped lip on the inside, and the factory gauge that's on the DRS is a 23 mil. So fits right in here. This is about the center line of the gauge, so I do need to widen this up quite a bit. So I have this old 28 mil gauge I'm just going to use as a reference, but I'm going to be using one of the Secmet gauges off of my Pantera. So it almost fits, but it doesn't. But it actually needs to be a little bit wider than this because the top here kind of still comes in at the top. So I just need to take off a little bit of material around here with a grinding bit. And then once I Cerakote the chassis again, nobody will even know that I did anything. So that's the first step. The second stage is to adjust the angle and the width of this little channel right here, which is for the hammer spring. So I'm going to make it a little bit shallower of an angle and just widen it up a bit. So you can see already, just from trying to adjust it initially, it's already kind of chewing up the chassis right here. So once I get this Cerakoted again, I don't want to have all these marks right here if I don't need, but I also just want it to be easier to access without having to worry about damaging the spring tensioner system that's in there, because I don't want to get the Allen key at like a weird angle and start turning it and it kind of mars that up inside. So I'd rather adjust this chassis than mess up the air gun itself. All right, so for any of the MDT purists out there, I would turn away. I'm about to destroy this beautiful chassis. I think it will be a good modification, but I'm sure this is going to rub somebody the wrong way that I am cutting into a brand new chassis. So if you get triggered easily, you might as well just leave. Leave now while you can. Let's turn the speed down a little bit and get ready to go. All right, guys, so I got done doing the initial grinding. So I widened this up, and then I widened this channel out as well. So here is my 28 mil testing gauge, I guess you can say, for right now, with a shroud on it. And you can see that it fits nice and flush in here. And before I did this, the 4.5 mil, which I believe is what the size is, was very tight. And now I can get a 5 mil even in here with a little bit of space. So now it is not so tight of a fit. I don't have to worry about marking up the chassis as much when I start trying to adjust it, and I can get a better angle into the hammer spring adjustment so that I don't mar up any of that adjustment wheel that's inside of there. So I think this was a pretty good little bit of an upgrade. And I know this looks dramatic, but I really didn't have to take off that much material, you guys. It's not that big of a difference, to be honest. This is, I cut it out to about 29, it's almost at 30 millimeters. So like I said, and this is the carbon fiber cover, which is a little bit thinner than those factory plastic FX ones, which I really do like those a lot. And I might use one of those. So if I do, I might have to widen this out just a tiny bit more. But for right now, I got the main part of it done. The next part is just to, I want to take a hand file and just refine this profile and make sure I can get a good lip going around it. Kind of how this factory bevel is on the edge, and just clean it up and make it look really nice. And then once I Cerakote this, you won't even be able to tell that I did anything. So that was a little bit nerve-wracking, but it was not that hard to do. So I will probably end this video here and get on to the next step of modifying this DRS, which is probably making some of the internal weights out of a brass block that I have. And so that will probably be the next video, I guess, on how to make some budget weights. And then I guess it's on to Cerakote, I guess. So thanks for sticking around, guys. I'll see you guys on the next one. Bye.